guys, my name is Courtney. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be discussing Chihayafuru Season 3, Episode 13. Chihayafuru is back from its break. I am so happy that it's back. Just as soon as the opening song started playing, I just became so happy. The show makes me happy. I'm also very glad that they didn't change the opening and ending songs yet. They still might in the future, but I've grown fond of them and I don't want to see them go. But let's get into this episode because it was just... There wasn't like a lot of drama or a lot of things happening, but it was ripe with thematic and symbolic things. It was good. So the beginning of this episode, we have the Queen's qualifiers match. Because Harada-sensei forfeits the second match, it's just the Queen's playing the second match. And so we get a couple snippets from their game. I believe the girl's name is Inoku Haruka, that's the mom. But it's mainly from the mom character's perspective. You know, we get these ideas about her experience, the time she took off to raise a family. The idea is if she's putting herself before her family. Those are all repeated, but it's also this idea of like the younger generation getting better than you, you having to adapt. And we learn that, you know, her sense of hearing is not just her skills. It's not just instinct. She's actually honed this craft so that she can do it on command. And it's something that Chihaya has just started to pick up and learn as well. So it's great to see it from a character who knows what they're doing with it. I love this character. I love her journey and her arc. I just love what she brings to the show. It's just so fascinating. And both the female characters are putting their best foot forwards. They're putting their dignity on the line, if you will, to play this match all out. So Haruka ends up winning and she's going to the Queen qualifiers, and we get this kind of idea about losing, which I really love because I feel like it's a big pinnacle of the show. Just this idea that it's not just about experience, like losing is so important to Karuta because that's where you really change and learn things, and if you don't lose, like Shinobu never loses, then you don't really learn that much. I love that message. I love what that brings to the table because I feel like that is like a big part of the show, is the characters losing and changing and growing. This idea that it's hard at the top, it's hard by yourself. This show is really about friendship and camaraderie and rivalries and growing. It's so good. And then we get a little gag with Suo-san and Chihaya. Chihaya's kind of followed Suo-san and is trying to like gain knowledge from him, and Suo thinks that she's making advances onto him. You know, the jokes in the show are kind of stupid, but like they're funny to me. I was snickering the whole time. It's so dumb. This is teasing at what's going to come and I'm so excited. Ugh, I'm anticipating it so much. And then after that, we learn what Chihaya said to Haruta. She said, Haruta's our mentor. You have to be more than just yourself to beat him. And so we really see Haruta take that to heart. And he starts to imitate his grandfather while he's playing and really take on his playing style. I personally love that. It's just so symbolic of how important his grandfather is to Haruta's arc and journey. It really backs up my premonition that, you know, Haruta's going to the finals to become master. That is his destiny. That is his goal. And it's so a part of his personal journey and arc. But it's so interesting in this episode because, you know, I've been talking about experience versus youth. These kind of generations battling and playing against each other is so important to this series. And in this episode, it's kind of inversed. Because Haruta-sensei knew Haruta's grandfather, he's played against him when he was very young. And so he kind of playing badly in a way, because Haruta is being so much like his grandfather, he starts to like revert back to his older past self, but he's playing invigorated. And now it's Haruta who's made up this experience, who's kind of invented this experience for himself. Because what Haruta was lacking in the first match was his experience, so he kind of takes on a persona of experience. Whereas we have Haruta-sensei, who all he needs is vitality and a younger body to play the way that he plays. And he has so much endurance. He's one of the oldest players that still plays competitively, but you know, it's not enough. Through this experience, he kind of reverts back to someone who is youthful and spirit, and he's having such a good time doing it. And it's so interesting that the author flips this. And then we have this great moment where reality comes back to Haruta and his knee is hurting and he realizes, I can't play that way. I can't do it or else I'm gonna hurt myself. And then we kind of end the episode with Suo-san saying, I want to play Haruta-sensei. That's the person I want to play in the match because he is interesting to me. Suo-san is just such a mysterious character. You know, you want to know why he finds Haruta-sensei interesting. Just seeing this episode, like, I know how much Haruta sensei means to me. I know how important he is. I'm rooting for him like 100%. Sorry, Arata-kun. I want Haruta sensei to win so badly, but I want to know Suo-san's reasonings, and I want to see Chihaya and Taichi with Suo-san learning things from him. This was such a good episode. So good. I definitely want to rewatch it again. Oh, I just want to see it again. It's so good. We ended mid-match, so there's still a little bit more of the match to go. Again, I am hoping that Haruta sensei gets there. I think Arata-kun is going to learn a lot from losing in this match if he does in fact lose. And I know him losing is going to do so much for his personal arc, for Taichi and Chihaya's as well, and I'm so excited to see it. And I'm sure there's going to be some kind of tense moment between the love triangle in the next episode, or at least I'm hoping so. One of the things I love about this show is that when somebody is impacted by something, it doesn't just affect them and their character growth, it affects everybody around them. Taichi and Chihaya and Arata learn from their own experiences, of course, but they learn so much from each other and each other's losses and wins, especially these three characters because they're so deeply connected and tied to each other. And I'm just so, so excited to see where this series goes. So thankful that this is being stretched out, that we get to see more Karuta. This episode was beautiful. I loved everything that they did with it, and I'm just so excited to see the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys next week with episode 14. Thank you so much for watching, and happy watching!